Hey, what's going on YouTube? Today we are inside of Affinity Designer and I want to give you a quick tutorial on using the pen tool. A lot of people feel a little overwhelmed with this tool because they're not too sure where to start or how it works. But what I'm going to do is I'm just going to run you through a very quick and easy process of how we use this. So as you can see in front of us, I've got a few basic shapes here that I drew out, and we are going to use these as a template or just something to trace around so I can demonstrate the tool. So I'll include this project file in the description if you want to download it and use the same shapes and follow along to this. So before we begin, if you pay attention to the right hand side layer panel, you can see that I've got all of these layers here locked. And what that does is it stops us from moving anything around here while we're drawing or tracing around them. Okay, so what we're going to do first is head over to the left hand side panel and we're going to choose the pen tool, which is that one right there. When using the pen tool, you just got to create a start point, which we're going to do in this top left hand corner of this box. And I've got snapping enabled here, which is going to make it a lot easier in terms of tracing around this. If you don't have snapping turned on, just come up to your top menu bar and ensure you've got that little red magnet checked up there. Okay, so we're going to create our first start point, and we do that simply just by tapping on your mouse. And you can see now we've got this little blue box. And when it comes to doing square boxes, this is really simple because it's straight lines all the way around. So this is going to be really quick and easy. It's just a case of coming down to the next bottom corner and tap again on your mouse. Over to the right hand side, tap again on your mouse. And back up here, tap again. And at this point, this is what you would call an open path, because we haven't quite made the shape into a square yet. So if anyone ever refers to something being an open path, it's because it's not combined with the start point, meaning that it's not a full shape. So once we now connect this over here to that one, it actually becomes an official square, and we can just come over here and we can color that as well. So if you want to, we can come over here and just turn off this stroke, which is what we just drew. And now you can see on here that we just simply have the square itself. Okay, so before we start on the circle, I just want to demonstrate how we would make curves with the pen tool. So if we come back over to the left hand side and we select that again, and once again we're just going to make a start point, so we just tap anywhere on the canvas that you like, and I'll just put the end point there. So we've got a straight line here, this is our start point, that is our end point. So if we just hold down our mouse button on this square right here and we start to pull over to the right hand side, you can see it's starting to curve over to the left. And if you pull down, it starts to move up. So everything's kind of backwards. So if you move up, then you can see your curve is starting to come down. And if you just come back over again to the left hand side, it starts to make its way over to a straight line once again. And if you pull over to your left, it starts to go right. So a way really to understand is just go backwards and it's going to do the opposite. So if you're going to go up, it's going to go down. If you're going to go down, it's going to go up. And it's just a case of going left to right to get in the kind of curve that you want. And the higher you go up or down, the more the curve is going to travel up the line. So I hope that kind of makes sense to you. So I'm just going to delete that because we don't need it. Okay, so with the circle, we've just got to kind of vision 4 points around this. So we've got this top one, this left one here on the side, we've got the bottom one and the right hand side one as well. So when it comes to curving around a bend like this, we can't just simply start from the top and go to the bottom and bend here, because it's not going to line up perfectly around here. So I'll quickly demonstrate that. I'm just going to grab this and start to drag over to the right because I want to go to the left. So if you remember, just do everything backwards. And no matter how we try and line this up, it's not going to work out right. We've got this gap now at the bottom and the top, as you can see. So this is why we need to vision the 4 points and kind of make our way around that. So I'm just going to delete that and we'll start again. So if we come up to the top, we put our start point on this one and we head over to the left hand side point and we put another one there. Now we can start to bend this around this shape. Just like that. See, it looks a lot more better than it did before, and we've got the general shape that we are going for. And now we just need to join this one down to the bottom. So before we do that, I just want to demonstrate here, this little round bit symbolizes that we are curved, whereas on the square it shows that we are straight. So that's kind of a start point, and this shows that we're on a curve. So if I was to leave this round now and come down here and tap there, I'm not going to be able to bend this in the way I want it to go. It's not going to line up either. So that can throw you off a little bit. So what it is actually trying to do is follow this line just down there. And I'm just going to undo that because we don't want to do that. So before moving on to this point down here, we need to convert this to a square like we got up there. And to do that, we just got to simply tap on it, just like that. So now that creates another start point like we had up there. So we're free to come down here, tap there, and we can just start all over again and now start to bend around this piece. Just like that. And once again, we've got to convert that to a square by tapping on it and then back up here. Do the same again, just drag that round. Remember left and right, up and down, just to get the kind of shape that you're going for. So just like that. This won't be perfect. I'm trying to rush it a little bit, but you would never hand draw a circle anyway. You'd use the tools. Once again, turn that to a square. So at this point, we can't just join this one to this one because we're not going to be able to curve it the right way either. So I'm going to demonstrate that quickly. So we're going to close that path. And as you can see, I haven't got the control to bend that where I want it. It's kind of messed it all up. So I'm just going to go back with Command Z on the Mac and Control Z on a Windows computer. And back to where we started. And what we're going to do here is we're going to come really close to this, as close as you can get without it snapping. And we just put that right there. And then we're going to start to bend it to get the general shape that we want. And then at this point, we need to come over here to the left-hand side and change the tool to this node tool, this little white triangle right there. So once you select that, I just want you to come back over to your circle and we can move that, as you can see. And I just want you to drag it over to the square on top of it so it turns yellow. So now that is locked into that, so that we now have a closed path, which is a shape once again. But this time around, we can come over here to this handle and we can adjust this to get the shape that we needed. Like that, as you can see. And then we can just simply color that as well, like we did before. We are on a stroke there at the moment, so I'll change that back to black and I'll change that fill to a different color. And like I stated before, if you want to, you can just turn off the fill altogether so we're left with the circle itself. So with this cloud kind of shape down here, it's the same principle as the circle. We've got a kind of vision some points, so one here, one there, and one there. So if we grab that pen tool again so I can demonstrate, we'll just start off here, and then our next one needs to be somewhere in the center here, because if we were to go straight down here and bend it, we're not going to get that curve that we wanted, same as we did originally on the circle. So I'm just going to Command Z to get rid of that, or Control Z on the Windows, and we'll just start again. So if we just start our point right there, come roughly into the center, just going to start to bend that by pulling to the left hand side so it goes right, change that again to the square, back down to this one and bend that around, and it is literally the same thing all the way around this shape. So all you got to really remember is just keep changing that back to a square, otherwise it may throw you off a little bit and send you in the wrong direction. That was a mistake, sorry. And just keep making your way all the way around it until you've got the shape. Okay, so I speeded that a little bit up for you, so you don't have to sit there watching me draw all the way around this. So just as a quick recap, remember at the top of this, like we did on the circle, we have to make sure that we don't connect this from there to there, as we're not going to be able to make that bend. So once again, just get as close as you can without it snapping, draw your rough shape, and grab that node tool again and just connect these together till it goes yellow, and then we can just move that however we like, and then we've got our complete closed path once again. So we just give that a color as well. Always color the stroke by accident. There we go, turn that stroke off. And that is that one. So if you hit escape twice, that will actually come off the shape for you. And what we've got next is this heart, but it's pretty much all the same as what we did. You've got to vision your curves and your points to get it around the way you want it to go. So if we just grab our pen tool once again, and we just start off here with a heart, I'm guessing it's gonna have to be roughly around there. It will be trial and error, and you will learn as you go on using this tool in the future. See, that's a pretty good curve. So from here, probably down to around there will be the next one. That's it, just like that. And then always change this to the square if you're having problems with your curve. And there we go. And then all we've got to do really is just line this up. Now it should snap on each point to come back up the other way. There we go. That one snapped to that one. And once again, we're closing this path. We can't join them together like we did, so get as close as you can. So there will be fine. And we just draw that shape. Grab that node tool and connect those together. And just adjust your handle. Give that a color. Make sure we are on the fill this time. And it's not a perfect heart, but you get the general idea what you got to do. The more time you spend on it and get your curves better, the better it's going to look. So the last but not least is this one, which is just something I created with the pen tool just to show you how easy it really is. So if we just grab that pen tool once again and we start off here, this one is simply a straight line. So we just start there, we come there and we click. So there's our first straight line. And then from this point down here, we've got to kind of break this up in the middle. So if we put another point there like that, we can now start to bend that around that corner. And it's kind of the same thing down here. If we make that into a square, and we're just going to break this up into the center here with this curve. And I'm just going to undo that because it wasn't quite where I wanted it. We just got that snap. So there will be fine. And we can just bend that down by bringing it up. And same again, just drag that right to the end, and then we can just slightly curve that a little bit and get the general shape that you want, and hit escape twice to come off that. And that's got no color stroke on it. That's why you can't see it, because I turned it off a moment ago. So if I put black back on it, you can see that line. So that is all there is to it. It's really straightforward. If you just take a little bit of time, just go around some few basic shapes, you'll get the idea of how this tool works and how great it generally is. It's something you will use 90% of the time when it comes to doing any kind of vector work or tracing around sketches or any kind of thing like that. So I hope you enjoy the rest of your day. If you found this useful, hit that subscribe button to check out any other videos I've got currently and coming in the future. But for now, I will see you in the next video.